So, where do we leave off? So, at the end of the last episode, we put in this thing. So, if you didn't already see it, right now there's actually no holes like that. So, if we click this button, these things will come out in sequence and then drop down whatever carts are on top. We may have to adjust this later on if it turns out that there's, you know, issues where when we actually have like larger trains and things like that, or like actually maybe as a good example, let's see what happens. So when you click this, there's a built-in delay with that, so we'll have to keep that in mind. But in a second, we'll see. I'll try and angle it so I can actually see everything. Make sure everything works okay. At some point, I'll time the delay and I'll put the instructions on there. Interesting. Okay, so there's actually, because they do come up at different times, so it actually will open up twice, which is fine. Maybe I'll try and adjust it so that, I guess this one's going a little bit slower, maybe, and so that it'll kind of fall at the same time, maybe. Anyway, either way. All right. So let's work on building some more stuff here. I don't have any more quartz still, so we won't do that part, but I can grab the rest of the building blocks, mainly andesite, and I might have to grab some more from downstairs too, although I think actually I still have some more in here, so never mind. How is everybody? So you're sick, Kota. How's everybody else doing? It's interesting the different sort of shows. So, Factorio is a lot more like lots of thinking. I mean, I guess because I'm still fairly new at it, so there's a lot of like figuring stuff out. And I guess it seems like less chatting. But then here, it seems like there's more. Let's bump these guys to go back down. Here it seems like it's more chatting, less figuring stuff out. It's kind of interesting dynamic. All right, cool. They're right there. So let's go ahead and build. I guess we'll go upstairs. Do I have quartz? Do I have enough quartz to do a little bit of planning? Let's see. No, that's iron. Okay, so no, not really. I have nine quartz blocks. Okay, so I'll have to get more quartz later. For now, we'll just use other blocks, maybe. Oh well. So let's go ahead and head up here. And we can start working on the stuff up here. So there's gonna be stairs coming up here. So this is open. I guess at the very least I can. Hey, bike guys. I can go like this, and then this is going to be the top here. So this is going to remain as it is now. This is probably going to be quartz, I guess, and then the quartz is going to continue along here as well, for wherever that stuff is. If it's three wide, then it would also be here. So that doesn't leave a lot of space here. So maybe it might be a longer stuff with maybe openings on both sides, or maybe this is just one big area on top. I don't know. This doesn't have to be. Oh, no, wait. Three. So it'd actually be out to here if I were to do it that way. All right, yeah. So then if I want to divide this in half, how many blocks is that? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. So there'd be 6. That's still, yeah, that's enough space. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So here's the wall. That will continue on the inside. And then I'm not sure how far over it'll go quite yet, but let's go ahead and put in, I guess, the rest of the floor. Yeah. I think of how I want to lay this out. I can at least do the rest of the floor in this part here. And then I can decide as I get closer over there how I might arrange things. But this part in here will be the same sort of floor. Going all the way across. I figure we'll just work on building out this mall a little more. Eventually, I'll have to come up with how I want to do some of the stores in the inside. I mean, some of them might be other people, but I'm sure most of them I'll need to make myself. I probably don't have enough people that I could convince to build stores over here for the amount of stores I have. So I have to come up with different ideas for that. So I guess I'll just put this whole thing in along the floor here like this. And then, I can come back and take stuff out as needed. Okay, cool. And then, yeah, I don't know if it's gonna be open over here or exactly what I'm gonna do for this section quite yet. Like, I could have this floor. Right now, I have bridges here because there's rail underneath there, but this top part can be however much I want connected over. So, not quite sure on that yet, but we will go and just go as we go. I haven't planned the whole thing out quite yet. Just sort of figure it out as we go. So if these are three, if there's six wide on the inside, I might do 6x6. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Boop. 1, 2, 3. Hello, Gigi Bunzig. Welcome to this is Patron Tuesday. I forgot to mention. My patrons have chosen that I will play Hypermine today. So I guess the other thing to consider here is that right now I have this indented. So here is this path, but then here I have it right now not, you know, kind of being an opener area. So maybe it's gonna curve. So if I'm keeping the three open, it will be like this. So this one will actually be 7 wide instead, this door. And then it curves around here, and then it can come back in. So if I keep this open like this, that would be here is where that would line up. And so then this would be a little bit, need to be a little bit different shape probably. So this guy is also 7 wide. So I'm either going to have a single opening, probably, or potentially 3. So it'll be a larger door. Now this guy, I might have this bridge over, actually. So it might not be open to the rail down below. So this might just continue across. And then on the bottom, I'll have some sort of arc. Although, again, I can't arc with these, so it still could be an arc, but not stairs, you know. So let's see how wide this is. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, I missed 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Interesting. Well, that's fine. I mean, it doesn't have to be even. So then, I guess 5 and 4 seems. I mean. Yeah, it seems small, but I guess it's not necessarily the end of the world. So let's have the smaller ones on this side. No, let's have the smaller ones on the less pretty side, maybe. Because that's just looking down at the exit area. So let's have this go across. And then maybe these are 4x4, or maybe these are like 4x5. So probably a 3 opening is my guess. Although, I guess if this is glass, so it's probably more like that, I guess. So open this up. So this actually lines up perfect with this end, but I have a feeling I'm going to extend this all the way over. Still. That's my plan. So over here, this is 5. We could still do 5. So it'd be 4, 5. Across like this, and then a single opening over here. It would be here, and then this would be here, and then I might still actually have this floor just go over the whole area, not actually use a bridge. So that's good there. I think it's probably lit up enough. If not, we have a bed, so we can make it day when we need to. So I'll need to keep an eye on how I'm going to get over to this section here. Because there's probably going to be something over here. These stairs are coming up. I don't know the exact... how steep they'll be. I guess we can work on that. So this is going to be presumably quartz. And then here is where the stairs would start, I guess. So stair blocks. So this is kind of the path. Okay, so then there's going to be stairs on top of this. This is going to be flat, I guess, quartz. So let's come up here. And then we'll make it be three wide. So this is regular quartz. And then regular quartz, stairs quartz, coming up to this main level. So this is regular quartz here. Stair quartz, stair quartz. So it's going to come up a little bit of a platform and then turn. If that makes sense. I need to get more quartz, but what I want to do is find out... so here there'd only be three wide there. So maybe I want to extend this over actually two more, like that, and then that'll let me have a railing for the stairs going down, and then three to then loop around to this section. So let's extend this this whole section here. I guess part of the reason why I did it the way I did was because it lined up with this wall. I think I still want to keep that open, but I'm going to extend the roof here to go a little further. So it's going to go out two more, I think is what I just decided. And we were just talking about making a day, so let's do that. Just in case I have dark spots. Alright. Yeah, that's good. That's cool. I think the ladder going up. Or the stairs, I guess, now. this will be granite. So I get my new computer on Thursday. Pretty excited. And I actually don't have a stream on Thursday because I'm getting a haircut. So that'll kind of work out. It'll give me time to work on my computer. Yeah, I'm excited. Let's see. So this is going to be this, and then I might do... This is going to be quartz here. So I might have these be this block, and then have... stuff on top of that. I'll have to see how I might set that up. But yeah, I'm getting a new computer. It's been about 4 years or so since I got this one. Oh, and we can't... Oh, the other thing I didn't consider with this plan is that, yes, I'll have three here, but I don't necessarily want to have it directly over this because they're going to hit their heads. So... for now, since I'm short on quartz, maybe I'll make a different material stairs so I can get an idea of the height. So let's do that. I don't know where my pickaxe is, or my regular axe. Okay. Alright, so let's put in... So this is going to be quartz, and then stairs coming along here. This, and then regular, and then stairs coming up. So those are going to be quartz. So we, so potentially what I was looking at is this, but obviously that's not going to work. so how far over do we need to move it? I mean, this will function, but is this too small of an opening? So if this continued all the way over to the wall, yeah, that's not good. So I had to come there. So I think that feels good. Yeah, that should be enough. Alright, so now I need to look at the top to see. So it's going to be here, and if I want it to be three... Well, I guess I couldn't even necessarily do three wide easily, because this block is going to stay like this. This whole X section here is giving me trouble. Oh, the other option, I mean, yeah, I guess these stores, this common area Yeah, okay, maybe I'll extend this over a little more again. So let's go a little bit further out. I'm gonna try and keep this, you know, thing looking down, but to be able to get around up here, it's a little tricky. But we'll try this. And then I just made it a little bit further than I needed to. Let's see. So this is here. And if I wanted to have quartz going along over there, that's the wall. So that's the three quartz. So it'd be regular wall, and then here would be quartz still, and then this is where it's gonna be. So it actually will extend this far out. Far out, man. Running low blocks. Okay. Boop. Okay, cool. And then we can, I'll make this, in case this is exposed, I'll change that over to that block. This will be like that. And now this can be railing. It'll come all the way out to here. So this potentially will be all the way over. I'll have to still build, redesign what the wall is going to be like on the upper parts. So this is quartz. And that'll continue that direction. So this will be like another walkway, maybe with some like seats and stuff to be able to look out the windows that are going to be here. And then otherwise it'll continue over this way. So this is going to be a fairly wide walkway. So this is going to be a railing here. Do we have things we can signify a railing with? I guess we can put in a railing. That may change the type of block it is. Minecraft. Okay, hold on. There we go. So this will be... So flat there. Probably like that. Railing there. Oh no. Okay, there we go. Railing. Well, I already ran out. That was quick. That's cool. Welcome back. One of these days I'll figure out how this all works. Okay, take this out. And then over here, so this is gonna be quartz, and then this is actually where the wall is, so we don't need this piece here. Let's rearrange these. There we go. I found my axe. Okay, good. There's gonna be a wall here with a big window looking out. Quartz running all the way this way. This block here. This will continue this way. So this is the ceiling at this level here. So I'm gonna put that in. I'll have to grab some more andesite shortly. But we can put in this. And then I'm kind of assuming that this is gonna be andesite running along here also. I believe these pillars might stay. And then we put in this roof here. Nope. Okay, good. Don't have to go resupply quite yet. Okay. And then we have a line of granite, right? Yep. Granite. And I guess I'll put in where these spruce are, assuming we're keeping those. I will put those in also. So this is going to be, I'm going to replace part of this floor that I'm putting in right now is actually going to be, oh, no. And actually, this is not exposed. No, this is, actually you can see that from underneath, so we will keep that as granite. I'm still eyeballing, better lighting. I'm getting a new computer, but I have my eye on a new mic and new lighting, things like that, but not quite there yet. I have to, I would just get it, but I don't want to. My wife to freak out. All right. Looks like I need more andesite. And actually, this will be fence on this side, assuming that. I don't know if I'm gonna go with like spruce or if I'm gonna do netherrack. I'll see what netherrack looks like, or other colored fence. But for now, we'll stick with this. Going along the edge. Like that. And then let's go ahead and get some more blocks. Whee. Okay. Good. And we probably want... We have quite a few of that, actually. Let's go ahead and just stick with andesite for now. We're gonna need quite a bit of it. All right, let's go for now. I thought I heard a villager for a second there. No, I guess not. That was weird. Okay. So we'll just do the ladder for now to get up top. This will come around. So this whole floor will all be quartz. I feel like, I mean, that's a lot of space in here just for a floor, but I guess that's fine. That happens. And maybe I can put something in the middle. Maybe there's like a, I don't know if there's quite enough room for a kiosk of any sort, but maybe I can have like, you know, buy cell phones here and whatever. Or like, it's probably not enough for a Starbucks, but. Alright, for now, we'll put in this floor. Eventually, we'll take this out and put in quartz instead. Probably. And this will continue on that way. So this will be a regular wall. I guess I can... Let's go like this. I can probably put in the rest of the pillars, I guess. I'm assuming I'm going to keep the same pillars all the way through. See. So those are here. Let's make a day real quick, just to be safe. I have this here. So that is that block, and then the next one is here. And then the next one is here. Right? Yep. Boop, 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 boop. And then I think, yeah, so it's bottom block and then that, and then three. So yeah, this would be, I'm not sure how it's gonna work with this. I'll have to think about that. Is there a colored stained glass that's like similar to this polished thing? I wonder. But for now, we'll just do like this. And then does this happen to be a pillar? Oh no, it's right here. That's fine. And then this will continue over. So that'll be a big window, but there's stairs there, so I'm not exactly sure how it's all going to line up quite yet. But for now, we can put this in. And then the window could go all the way down to the bottom, I guess, actually. Similar to pink or the gray. Ah, the pink. The granite, and gray, I guess. I mean, the gray, I think that it was light gray is what we're looking at, is similar. So I could actually put light gray along here, and then maybe if there are going to be benches here, I don't know if you want to look out the window or over this way. It's hard to say, I guess. I don't know. But I could have this go lower down, I guess, these windows. I have to think about that. But this will continue over that way. I guess it's time to work on that side. Let's make sure everything is lit up over here. Yeah, I'll have to think. Yeah, the pink might be too pink, is my guess. That's my guess. We'll see. Okay, so we don't know exactly how the second floor will meet up with the other side, but for now, we will just work on the first floor on this side. So these are stairs going up, I think is what I was trying to indicate here. And so I might have to go up and then loop around or something. So it's gonna have stairs going up there and I guess there. That might be overkill. Or not overkill. I guess we'll find out. For now, I'll work on this stuff on the inside here. So this is gonna be the regular floor. And then we'll have to add the lighting in later. But for now, I'll just put in the regular, just put in the whole floor as is. We'll add the lighting stuff in later. I'm gonna put the stained glass inside the floor like we did in, I guess we haven't done that yet on any of those. So I haven't quite picked out my games. This weekend, if you haven't already found out, is a board gaming weekend for me. So if you are around, I'm going to be streaming it all, hopefully with a side, like a face cam sort of thing, side view, as well as the top view. Top view for sure. Side view if I can get it to work. Last time I had issues, technical issues, with getting it to work. But I think it might be solved. Gopher helped me debug my USB stuff, and I think it's more about which ports I was using, less about like the ability to use that many ports, if that makes sense. So I think that we might be able to do it, hopefully. And then granite, which we actually don't have a lot of right now. Oh, I have enough. So it'll be pretty cool. Last time what we did that worked out pretty well was that each of us, there's four of us, so each of us picked out a game. Thank you for the host, a little spooky. Each of us picked out a game that we wanted to play, a board game, and then you know, we took turns on who gets to play whatever game they wanted to play. Actually, these walls are going to come out anyway. These are going to be glass, but whatever. So I have to pick out which one I want. Last time I think I did... What was my game last time? I can't remember now. But anyway. So we each pick out a game that we want to play. I think one of... Like, we played Verticulture, and we played a couple other ones. So I might have to pick out, like, some cool strategy game. Welcome, Little Spooky. We're working on the rail station right now. Building out the walls. Can I get over there? Nope. I probably could have, but I screwed up the jump. Alright. Okay, then there's a ceiling on top of this. Oh yeah, this stripe is inside the floor. Okay. I convinced my family to have a stress-free Thanksgiving. And we played games all weekend instead of shopping. Awesome. Yeah, I played spades actually for the first time. That was pretty fun. But we had a little bit of shopping that was kind of stressful. I don't really understand why we did that. My wife's not a shopper, so it wasn't really her choice, exactly. We were at my mom's. She wanted to go buy clothes. Alright, I do need to put torches down here. Let's make some more torches. So we can just spam torches everywhere. Feel safe. The idea of the taking turns picking your game. Yeah, that's what we sort of accidentally did. Oh man, Agricola is so much fun. That's one that I really like to play, but it does take a while. And so, it's kind of those, like, we each can get in a game of our choice if it's not like too crazy of a game. But I mean, even with like a cola, I guess if everybody chose a game that was really, really long, it probably wouldn't work out too well. But we can usually get, you know, might be able to still do it even with that. But yeah, Agricola does take a while. Put the sticks in here so we can get some more space. Then I guess actually put away the stone. Nope, I'm sorry. Stone is over here. The stone bricks. And grab some more. We need lots of blocks. Eventually we're gonna run out and then have to go shopping downstairs. For now we're good. Yeah, Agricola, I really like that one. I really liked actually I'm sorry. Have you played Caverna? Caverna is the one that I'm more into now. It's sort of the sequel. If you're not familiar with it. It's pretty cool. It's a good game. Yeah, so it is, it's sort of like the sequel, to Agricola. So that, in this one, you are, your family of dwarves. And you, like, you can either, like, work on your farm stuff, you can excavate, your cave to build different rooms. So each of the rooms you can build have different like bonuses and things like that. And then also you need like rooms to be able to have a bigger family. And then also you could potentially, if you want, like you can go room route or you can go farming or you can go adventuring. And you could do any sort of combination thereof. But there's you could do farming. I'm sorry, where am I? Adventuring, well actually, I usually go adventuring, but I think next time I play, I might not, just to try it out. But the adventuring route, for me, seems like you get the most stuff, because you can still get, like, animals and stuff like that. And you can get, like, different upgrades and room upgrades just from adventuring. So, I recommend checking that one out. Caverna is the, it's a good game. Pretty cool. It's a little bit easier to score too. Like there's less complicated, like the, I remember that in Agricola, like the cows versus sheep and whatever, it was kind of weird for like trying to figure out the scoring. Whereas I felt like in Caverna, it was a little bit more straightforward. We should sleep soon. It does have a lot of parts. So, the other thing I recommend is buying a toolbox. if you want, after the stream, if you remind me, I can link you what I got. It comes with bags and stuff like that, but I found that it's actually easier to maintain everything if you have a toolbox. So, like, I have a thing that has a bunch of little compartments that all can come out. And then that way you can have all the pieces organized in the different compartments. And then each person can be responsible for repopulating a given resource back on the board in between turns, like in between rounds. It makes it a little easier with the little compartments as opposed to the bags that I found. But one thing I do recommend is having trying to keep the dogs and the cows in the woods separate because they are all brown little pieces, so it's harder to figure out what's what. So probably keep those separate. But yeah, it's a lot of pieces. Yeah, that was one where I didn't even know about the game, and so somebody else that I know online, she was saying that she told me about the game, and then she said, and you should also buy this particular This is, or at least that's the one that she was using. The toolbox thing. Works pretty well. I might add windows on the side of these, but for now I'm just going to fill it all in. Since I don't have all the glass yet, I need to still get that from, I guess, the Wasteland. Mesa has a bunch of sand I could probably steal. But for now, we'll do it this way. Like this. Oops. I'll have to kind of fix this up top of it. Oh, and I don't even know what this is. Okay. Okay, good. I have to remember to lay at the top before I walk away. That's good there. Actually, I think I probably only had those three high. Probably fill this in here. Yeah. So potentially this is where there's going to be stairs. So I don't know exactly where they're all going to fit in. But this is a wall here. And then these stairs, it might not be three wide. It might just be two wide here. But we might start it here, I guess. So these will be replaced with quartz later. Oops. With quartz later. But for now, we'll just use these. And then this is going to be here, like that. Just like that. And then this is the main floor here. And actually, oh, my bad. This is granite on this layer. I don't know yet if this is all going to be still open and looking down on the walkway there, or if I'm going to have sort of bridging areas over it, or quite exactly how I'll do it. But for now, I'll just build it in kind of as I have it right now and then modify it after the fact. I think is a way to do it in Minecraft. If you're actually building it, obviously, you would just plan out the whole thing, run it through a 3D program, and then see what it looks like, but in Minecraft, it's pretty easy to just tear it down. So we just put this in for now, like this, and I feel like this is probably just going to bridge right over, so we'll just do that. And then here... this will be granite or quartz here coming across anyway. So maybe because of this thing, I might use that as where it's going to bridge over. Maybe. We'll see. I did run out of blocks just now. That was quick. So I'll leave this as is. And then, I'll leave this part uncovered for now because I'm not sure what the plan is. Let's go grab some more andesite. I do enjoy, I think everybody gets annoyed with me whenever I play, Caverna. But, they get annoyed with me anyway. Oh, actually, one game that was a lot of fun was, Suburbia. I really enjoy it, because I like SimCity, and it's basically like SimCity the board game. I didn't win this last time, if you didn't see it. I still have to actually edit those videos. I haven't edited those yet. They didn't have a lot of views after the fact, but it's still nice to have like a kind of a history on online of the game. So I might still do it anyway. But so it's kind of like SimCity in a way. And like you're trying to build certain buildings that'll help out other buildings, or in like industrial will make residential next to it mad, and you know, the sort of regular SimCity stuff. I don't know why I came all the way up here. I'm about to jump down. Yeah, so that's a lot of fun. I like that one. Let's go like this. And then for now, we'll leave the wall as is. And I guess these are stairs, so I'm going to come back to this part. I'll start here. And this floor is very thin, so I have to make sure I don't break through and jump down. This is a little extra hidden wall thing. Like this. Right? Yeah. So eventually we'll have this all done, and then we can work on the rest of the stuff, like the building the shops and adjusting how all these things are placed together. Because I have a feeling that I might want to change what I've done. So this is going to be a wall here, coming along here. One thing I did discover, I haven't started watching it all the way yet, is Madam Secretary. My parents watch that show, and it seems like it's pretty cool. So I'm gonna start. I watched like whatever was the sort of newer stuff at their house, but I'm gonna go back to the beginning and start over. So that'll be kind of fun. New show to watch. Right now I'm actually hooked on Survivor, and I'm still catching up on all that. I am going to be watching Madam Secretary on Hulu, or I'm sorry, on Netflix. So I'll be behind. It'll be based on when it was on DVD. So like the stairs in are only going to be 3 wide, whereas like everything else here is, I'm sorry, it's only going to be 2 wide, whereas everything else is 3 wide. But oh well, I guess the leaving and coming and going out of the place through this walkway, I guess, is less important. It's kind of weird. But I guess that kind of makes sense. Sort of. Yeah, I guess stairs aren't always... Yeah, so Madam Secretary is... what channel was he watching it on? I don't know. I think it was one of the major networks. But I don't have cable myself, so I'll be watching it on Netflix on a delay of something. I'm not really sure exactly how much of a delay it's going to be, but we'll find out, I guess. It's probably like a season behind. Yeah, right. I still watch it on TV. It's just, actually, am I doing this right? Yeah. Yeah, what is this cable you speak of? I still watch TV on TV. It's just like not cable. But I realize that some people will probably just watch TV on computer. But we still sit in the living room and like watch TV. No, I guess this was... The idea here is that this would actually continue all the way over. And then here's where the opening is. Yeah. So this is going to be... This. Quartz will have to continue over. Let's make a day. I watched, I haven't been to the movies very much, but I did go see Fantastical Beasts, or whatever it's called. It was not my, I mean, it was entertaining enough. I also didn't have to pay for it. I mean, I paid for the popcorn, but that's, popcorn is worth it. but the movie itself, I was not as impressed with. I don't know if you guys have seen it, and if I'm, like, I don't follow the Harry Potter stuff as much, so maybe that's a factor. Also, I haven't like read that book or whatever, so that could also be a factor. But that particular movie just didn't do it for me. There was there's a lot of parts where I was like bored with the scene, and I just wanted to continue on with something else. We're good. What else is new with me? Yeah, mainly I'm just excited about my new computer. It's been pretty cool. My dog's is digesting the squirrel nicely, it seems like. Which is a good thing. If you don't know what I'm talking about, yesterday, my dog's, I think, jointly caught a squirrel, and then one of them ended up actually, like, getting to keep it, and then, ate it. I tried to get it away, and he kept on bringing it over to me to, like, play, but I didn't really want to play, like, tug-of-war with a squirrel. So, he just got to keep it and eat it, I guess. Let's see. Yeah, here we go. So I'll build just the foundation and, like, the start of the wall, and then I'll switch over to building the rest of it after that. But yeah, that's one thing that I've gotten used to as a dog owner, is that dogs are dogs. I think dogs are animals. And so, even like with my old dog, who had like a heart condition and stuff, like, you know, she would still occasionally catch like a, you know, a baby rabbit or a little rabbit or whatever, and then like kill it. She didn't eat it, but these dogs eat them. Got to keep. Yeah, it's pretty gross. It's still gross, but I'm more used to the fact that that's just the thing that they do. This way. Well, I go through blocks really quick with this building. Let's go get some more andesite. And also, so right now it might be jagged, the video, like, so as I move around. I mean, I don't have a lot of things open right now, but that's something I'm really excited about with my new computer. Is I'm hoping that the stream quality will be much better. I'll have lots more memory. I'll have a fresh OS. It'll be Windows 10, so whatever doesn't work will all of a sudden not work. It'd be great. Although the company I'm buying, it's a doghouse system, is the company. And that's where this computer is too, although it's pretty old. But the I'm excited about that they, you know, it'll be a good quality. I assume, from what I understand, it's going to be fairly quiet. I mean, this one's fairly quiet too, but it's the other one's gonna have like water cooling and stuff like that. So hopefully it'll be quiet enough, and not add extra noise. That's partly one of my concerns. So I emailed them to make sure that it wasn't gonna be like some big noisy thing, or like I had to worry about how to like maintain the water cooling. Yeah, because I think it's actually overclocked as well. So they're overclocking it or whatever. Like, they're setting it up so it's like a big gaming rig. So we'll see how it is. It'll be cool. This is also solid state hard drive too, but it's gonna be solid state hard drive and everything to be as fast and reliable as possible is what I was looking for. Take this out. Did I finish this off all the way? Yeah, okay, cool. Yeah, I've never done water cooling before. From what it sounds like, it's going to be a closed system that I don't have to maintain at all. That was always my concern, is like, I don't want a bunch of water in my computer. but this sounds like it'll be good. There's no... That would be unfortunate if all of a sudden I blew up. And I guess here. Yeah. For those that aren't in my Patreon, or in my Discord, didn't see it, I crossed 500 subs on YouTube. I'm really excited about that. I've been sort of watching it on the website. So it's like one of my phone. That's one of the my browser tabs is watching the subscriber count. I haven't really been trying to push it too much. I've just been sort of watching it so that I can be aware when it goes up. But I didn't want to like go overboard with like trying to get people to subscribe. Like I want subscribers that like what I have, and then they like watch my stuff. I'd rather have a low subscriber count but more people watching versus like a high subscriber count and people not really actually watching. So that's why I wasn't like trying to push to make people share it a whole bunch if those people didn't actually want to watch the things. I'd rather they don't want to do it, you know. Does that make sense? I think it makes sense. Right, exactly. Quality, not quantity. Okay, so what are we doing here? I'll come back to this section here. This is the service stairs going up and down, I think is the plan for this. We'll come back to that for now, though. And I guess I just realized I don't actually have to keep on taking out these corners because they're not going to be visible anyway. So we can just go like this. They're going to be visible on this side. So we will put those in there. Take this out. This is gonna go. Okay, good. No, wait, what? I guess it goes here. Okay. Okay, good. And then these won't be visible. So some of this, like whatever is here, is going to be a little cramped, but I don't know exactly what it's going to be, so that's fine. And this guy comes all the way over here. And right now it sticks out. There might be a pillar here, or maybe there doesn't need to be because it's against the hill. I don't know. But I can kind of fix up some of this stuff later. I'll put that there for now. I don't know what the makeup would be exactly, but this is good for now. And this is actually going to be granite, if I'm not mistaken. Yep. Good. Put it in the floor. If I had a turtle, I would just tell my turtle to build all this. But I'm not playing modded right now. And that's it. More blocks are needed. Let's make sure everything is lit. I really like my soundtrack for streaming. It's nice having a break from, a little bit of a break from, approaching Nirvana. It's pretty cool. Pretty proud of myself. Wait, what about turtles? When I played modded Minecraft, I pretty much focused like solely on turtles. So anything that I could do with turtles, I did with turtles, is what I was doing on the modded series. So there's this whole like, I can't remember the name of it, but there's like computer systems where you can store items in computers. And then just like retrieve them with a search thing. I was gonna build. I was gonna build like so they're robots. They're like little robots you can program. So I was using programming to get little like computers and little robots turtles to do everything in the game. So if I wanted to have build this floor, I would write a little program. Or actually, there might be an existing program for that, where I could just say, okay, all the blocks that are in your number one slot, place them down in a flat plane, going in this pattern, or dig out this whole area, and then here's the program that I want you to do it, where I want you to put down torches as you go, things like that. And so that, I could do all kinds of stuff with that, and I never finished the project, but I had a project where I was going to, have it take take supplies, figure out what chest it should go into, and then like have these big like storage cells of a whole bunch of chests, because they can float, these turtles. You could say move up, and then they can move up even though they're not on the ground anymore. So I could have just like a big pillar of chests where it can like pull items for the inventory. So I could say like store all this stuff, and then I could say I want 50 cobble stacks, and then it would just go into the chests, find, locate where they should get it from, keep track of the inventory of everything. It was a cool project. It wasn't working yet, but it was fun to do. All right, so we made a lot of progress. I will have to come back and finish off this, and then those walls, and then we'll work on how the second floor is going to kind of interact with everything else. Like somehow there's gonna be bridging together. I was talking about a food court on top of this, and I need to figure out how these stairs are gonna work exactly. But this is coming along pretty well. This is gonna be end of the stream. Thank you everybody for coming, making progress.